Hello, hello, hello. I'm back. As you can remember, the last time we found this track and we basically lost the blood trail. The last trail we found said we veered off to the east and now we're walking in an easterly direction. I don't see any tracks. Never mind blood trails, I don't even see tracks. So I believe that antelope is long gone. And I haven't got the notification to claim my trophy. So I believe he's still fine. Now, since we're not in real life now, I don't really feel any remorse. Basically, I don't feel bad walking away from him at this stage. Course we still have 3 rounds left. Now usually I go for about an open hunt, basically an episode per open hunt, but since we completed a regular mission as well, we basically ran on a bit too long, so I decided to split this. But I won't attempt another open hunt if we still have time left after these 3 rounds have been fired. I might attempt a objective hunt, you can say. I might attempt that, but we'll see. It might take me an entire episode so to just to track down 3 more animals. Let's just take a look if we can see anything here. If we find an animal that's slightly injured, we know it's ours, and we can attempt to track him down again. An uninjured female. That's the group we basically spooked while we were on the blood trail. So let's walk towards these animals. Now the first time I started this game, I shot a white-tailed deer and it ran off and I lost the track, but it was really a crappy shot. And after a while I got a notification to claim my trophy and I tried finding him again and I couldn't find him. So I just decided, oh well, that's just it, let's just continue our hunt. While I was tracking another antelope or another deer, I came across this weird looking branch in the distance. At closer inspection I saw it was my first white-tailed deer. By the time I left the trophy unclaimed, what basically happened there was an open hunt. It was an open hunt, and just as the time was running out, basically 10 minutes left, I shot this animal. It was a long shot, but it was quite a distance away. Because I had the
excellent shot placement. It won't go far.
Because I had the 3-9 times telescope. It was quite a distance away, it was fully zoomed in.
Stay alert for shifting winds. Keep downwind your target.
It was fully zoomed in, and when I shot the animal in the distance, and just as it was about this distance from the trophy, time ran out. So they counted it as an unclaimed trophy. And that was really heartbreaking. I can't remember how much the penalty was, but it was quite high. Basically, if you hit anything except the vital organs, I believe, if you hit a stomach shot, I believe that's the greatest penalty. If you claim a trophy, it's minus 100 gear credits. But the penalty for not claiming your trophy is a lot higher than that minus 100. So rather, if you shoot something in the stomach, rather claim it. But that's just my opinion. I really like the sound of babbling brooks. Seriously, I do. But I have to say, I'm a child of a bushveld. I really enjoy it. If I can go anywhere in the world at this stage, I would go to bushveld. That's how much I love it. And I have to say, not necessarily for hunting or angling or fishing, whatever you want to call it, just to be in nature. If you want to make me happy, take me to a bushveld and leave me there for a couple of days. I'm the happiest camper around. Last year, we went on a camping trip for our friends, basically. And one of the guys, he camped before, but he really never enjoyed it. He says always messy, and he always puddles after the rain, and it's always a bit miserable afterwards. But we went to a nice camping spot or place. I won't say the name because I don't want people flooding it. What the hell. Most people that watch this videos aren't from here, but it's a place in the Eastern Cape. So we went to this place. It was really, really quiet because it was after the madness of our December holidays. Basically, for everyone that doesn't know, the longest school holidays here in South Africa is basically over December. So basically, it's our summer holidays closed for about almost three months. During university, basically, they are finished by the end of October, beginning November. They finish with classes and exams. If you don't write the I don't know what they call it. I haven't written any of those yet. So I don't really know what they are called, but it's basically a second chance to pass your exams. But you only get one of those if you're basically busy with your bachelor's. You only get one chance to write an exam again. But it's not the same one, it's another one. Usually a little bit more difficult. But yeah. If you don't write one of those, you basically your university year ends at the end of November. You're basically off until mid-February. So what's that? It's December, January. It's basically 2.5 months of just summer weather, nice and sunny in South Africa. So it's basically madness. But we went after the New Year's rush. We went to this place in the Eastern Cape, four of us. And after that, we always just want to go back to that place. But we're also scared to go back because it might not be as magical as it was last year. But it's really a magical place, I have to say. That's basically the thing. Last year, when we were completing our master's degrees, four of us were sitting there just saying that at any time when things got kind of tough, we just said, why don't we go for a weekend to this place?
Watch the wind. You don't want to be caught flat-footed if you're suddenly upwind of the animals.
And it's about 900 kilometers from where we study, but it's about 13 hours drive because the roads, basically the last 200 kilometers, are a bit rough, to say the least. And there are lots of wildlife in the road and so on. So, you know, it's not too bad. We basically almost went there a couple of times since then. But at the end of the day, it's still, we don't want to go there just for the weekend. Because it's basically 13 hours to get there, 13 hours back. It's already more than a day, just in driving. And it's not what stops and getting something to eat. If you get something to eat, basically you grab a salmi, then you walk out with your sandwich, and that's it. And basically only have time until you're refueled. Because let's face it, when you go there, you might drag your feet a bit, but on your way back, you just want to get home. Just so you can unpack and unwind and just reflect on your vacation. But yeah, it's basically 13 hours that way, 13 hours back. So I think that's the only reason that we didn't go there since then. Because we completed our studies. Two of us are busy with our PhDs now. The rest of them started working. So, yeah, it's time to grow up, I guess. Let's try and see if we can spot them when we peek around this boulder. As I said numerous times, I don't like hunting animals from blinds or hides. I couldn't ask for a better stance from an antelope than what that female gave me now. So we have one round left. And 3 hours in this hunt. But as I said, we'll complete this and we might have time for another objective hunt or to complete an objective. From now on, if I say an objective hunt, it's basically a hunt to achieve an objective. For instance, hunt one white-tailed deer from a stand or a blind, those kinds of hunts. I want to be over hastily chasing these rest of that herd because they might have slowed down in the meantime. I have to say, in real life, the times I had the most fun and just relaxed the most is basically any time I'm sitting on a koppie or a hill. In Afrikaans, or basically in South Africa, you call it a koppie. You sit on a koppie, look out over bushveld. Basically, either at sunrise or at sunset. You just hear the veld come alive after the heat of the day. That's one of my favorite memories that I'll cherish forever. It's basically any time. No specific one, but basically any time I sit on a coffee in the bushveld. Let's rather pick a direction and walk towards it. I guess we'll go in that direction. I mean, it's not in our favor, but we only have one shot left. What do we track this animal? Let's rather track this animal. Making a lot of noise. Some more. You have a fighting chance. These tracks are 15 to 30 minutes old. Now, these ones as well. So let's just stay on these tracks.
Watch the wind. You don't want to get caught flat-footed if you're suddenly upwind of the animals.
Okay, we had some luck in on our side now. We're shifting winds, and I just got noise markers or noise warnings. Basically from three directions now. But let's see if we can spot anything close by. And let's attempt a shot so we can get on to the next hunt so we can unlock or basically buy our 7mm. I would be so much happier as soon as I get that rifle. Can we get onto these rocks? Yes, we can. Hopefully we can get to a high vantage point on these rocks. See, that's a problem now. I almost went for that fox. Okay, there's a nice male deer. Go prone. I think that might be a bit low. I deflected masterly.
That was close, but still off the mark. You need to practice your marksmanship to ensure a clean shot.
Just in case fall damage is a thing. No noise markers. I believe I shot him around here. Where's our rocks? There you go. Now that I'm thinking about it, I don't think this one will go down. So this might be basically.
Looks like you've run out of ammo. You need to be more careful with your shots in the future or equip some extra rounds.
Basically, I can only chase them off.
Recently. You should try your luck somewhere else. Let this spot cool down.
I went down at least, but I'll be losing gear credits. As you can see, 4,425. If I'm not mistaken, I'll only have 4,350 after this. 4,350. I lost gear credits on that last shot. But yeah, let's end this hunt since we ran out of ammunition. And let's see if we unlocked anything else. 4x scope. Recurve bow, 12-gauge shotgun, 4x scope. So we either, excuse the pun, we either bite the bullet and get a 4x scope, or we save up to get a 7mm. You know what? I'd rather go for the 7mm. It's just 4,000 gear credits further to get a 4x rifle scope. Otherwise, we'll go a bit further and get the 6x. But at the end of the day, these 3 to 12 scopes are only 60 to 65,000. Now, listen to me, only 65,000. So let's see if there's anything that we can, any hunt that we can take on now. Normal type of hunt, so no. So I believe this will be the end for now. So I'll see you back soon. Bye bye.